Hey guys, Jillian here for another installment of Tip Tuesday. And this week I want to talk a little bit about where it is that you get your health and fitness information from. So recently I watched, it was, you know, a comedy sketch on a show, and it was talking about science and, you know, the latest and the greatest from science as it ends up getting reported on like daytime televisions and kind of in popular magazines. And the bottom line was this: there were some really great points in the sketch. It was very newsy in its nature. And so he was talking about, you know, some of the faults that are at that happening within science right now. You know, scientists are under extreme pressure to maintain their tenure. They're under pressure from, you know, their funders to create new and fabulous discoveries at all times. And so a lot of the safeguards that were kind of in place previously about like replication studies, etc., that are out there to show us, you know, yes, this happened once, let's see if it happens again, to actually see if there is a true link between things or a correlation, not just a correlation but a causation, those aren't happening anymore, because it's not, you know, you don't get the big bucks for showing that something was true or not true. You get the big bucks for discovering the big thing. So this kind of just got my wheels turning, and just about fitness and nutrition specifically, and really as a consumer, my big tip for you today is to be mindful of where you are getting your information from. You wouldn't get information about your vehicle from a florist. They also shouldn't be getting information about your human body from somebody who doesn't have expertise in that area. And I really invite you to be critical thinkers when it comes to where it is you're getting your information, and, you know, what was the driving force behind that information? Is the source of that information trying to sell you something? Is what funded the study? If it's a scientific study, you know, is it a valid scientific study? Where was it published? Is it published in a reputable journal, or was it published in a, you know, funded by a magazine and published in a magazine? Because that has less credibility in my books. So just, I invite you to be more of a critical thinker when it comes to where you're getting your information from. And just remind you once again, I say this a lot, but just because it worked for one person doesn't make it fact that it's going to work for every single person. We need to not only be critical thinkers, but we really need to be individualized in our approaches, both to fitness and in nutrition, and really look at what works for us as individual, unique human beings. So that is my Tip Tuesday for today. A little bit of science for you and a little bit of just common sense, I think. But sometimes it seems that we forget to use our common sense when it comes to fitness and nutrition, because we're so keen to see those results. So take a deep breath. Know that the results will come when you're consistent with what you're doing and truly listening to what works well for your body and your unique makeup. Have a great day.